Culture is a selection of images. Some elusive, some vivid, others were printed indelibly on our memories. We shape our lives not by what we carry with us, but by what we leave behind and what falls into oblivion.
Hi, my name is Lee. I'm 18 years old. I was born and raised in Ho Chi Minh City, but I've moved to the US when I was 10.
Hello, my name is Joe. I'm 18 years old. I'm a student and I live in Ho Chi Minh City.
Hi, my name is Anh. I'm 18 years old, currently a student.
Oh yes, life seems more modern and also more busy, but what changed the most is the youth. Well, they don't do what we used to. I mean, back in the old days, we would play folk games such as hopping or jacks and bomb. But now children would just stick to their devices and play video games.
Well, completely. And I think this is saddening because these so-called traditional games are not only means of entertainment but also a part of the culture.
When I was young, I enjoyed rope skipping. You know, the one with an elastic rope and two people holding the rope at each end. Everyone jumps over the rope using different techniques. There are many adaptations to the game, so it never gets boring. To jump well, much strength and stability is required, so it is a good way to improve your health.
For me, the most appealing game in the world must be jacks and ball. You need 10 to 12 jacks for the game and a tennis ball. First, you toss the ball into the air, wait for it to bounce, and then use the same hand to grab a jack without touching the others, and then catch the ball. Complicated, isn't it? So you need a lot of flexibility and practice to be an expert in the game.
Well, speaking of board games, you can leave out this one. Hopping, my childhood favorite. Compared to other games, this one is comparatively easier. There's a drawing on the ground, competitive number squares. You hop into the squares, following the number to the other end, and back. Should you fall or step on the buzzer, you lose. This game is often played in group of 5 to 7 people. It's very fun.
I think that the high-tech trend is to blame here. I mean, stuff like iPod or Xbox or PlayStation, they are definitely more attractive to children, as they are full of sounds and images. No wonder the children turn their back on traditional games.
Well, I think the curriculum is also a reason. You know, these games are only fun when played in groups. However, assembling a group of friends when everyone is always busy going to tutor classes is no easy talk. That's why children just opt for individual video games.
The consequence may be great. I mean, look at it. The games we just mentioned are the most popular ones. Yet more people know not how to play them. So how about those less popular? Things like Đánh Đu, Hát Trầu Văn or Cờ Người. We will only find them in the museum.
I think we ruin our children's childhood not encouraging them to play such fun games.
A memory is a photograph taken by the heart to make a special moment last forever. So it will fade, but never lives. These traditional games are the most beautiful picture. So let the past and the present intermingles to bring out the essence. And past the folks,